old are you?
You might think it's a simple question, but it turns out your chronological age and your biological age might not be the same. Confused? Well, it's actually more complicated than that. Different parts of your body age differently too. If you're 30, you might have the immune system of a 40-year-old, but the kidneys of a 25-year-old. Or maybe you have a youthful immune system, but some age-associated metabolic issues. So you don't have a biological age per se, more like several of them. How do we know different parts of us age differently? Why do they? And can we intervene to anti-age specific organs? The science may be young, but we already have some answers to those questions. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. As a SciShow viewer, you can keep building your STEM skills with a 30-day free trial and 20% off an annual premium subscription at brilliant.org/scishow. If you're 30 years old, you might assume that all of your body is 30 years old. After all, your body all came together 30 years ago at roughly the same time. But that doesn't necessarily mean you have the immune system or liver of a 30-year-old. Different parts of your body can age at different rates, and scientists refer to those as your biological ages. Now, you may be thinking, this is all semantics. Just because your kidneys are in worse shape than the rest of you, that doesn't mean they're literally a different age. And that's true. But by studying systems in the body this way, researchers can identify risk factors for chronic diseases more easily. So, how are biological ages determined? By measuring biomarkers that can be collected accurately and reproducibly. A biomarker can be something as simple as blood pressure or more complex, like the levels of certain proteins or hormones in a part of the body. For example, biomarkers like the substance bilirubin in your blood could be used to predict liver aging, which predicts the severity of fatty liver disease. This could help catch problems early, and it's easy to get a sample. Scientists have been studying biological age for a while, but a study in 2020 really advanced our understanding of it. In that study, biomarker data was collected from a group of 106 participants ages 29 to 75 years old through blood samples, nasal swabs, and stool samples. There are some well-established aging biomarkers, such as the length of your telomeres, the protective DNA sections at the ends of chromosomes. But by using a group with a large age range, this team was able to establish other age-correlated biomarkers, like certain proteins, lipids, metabolites, and hormones. At the population level, it was easy to find the average levels of those biomarkers for a specific organ system at a given age. The study assigned biomarkers in four major systems: immune, metabolic, kidney, and liver. Let's take some of the age-correlated biomarkers they discovered in the immune system as an example. Your immune system has proteins called CCL27, ORAI1, and ITPR2 that help regulate stuff. CCL27 is involved in making sure your tissues have the right numbers of immune cells in them. ORAI1 helps coordinate the activity of some of those immune cells. And ITPR2 contributes to cell signaling in immune response. They all have a role, but if you have a lot of these immune-related proteins in your body, you're going to have more inflammation. Increased inflammation is associated with aging in other parts of the body. Inflammaging, if you will. So the research team was able to show that certain biomarkers are correlated with aging of particular organ systems. But the study was able to do more than that. They followed the group over the course of 4 years, so biomarker levels could be studied over time. Compiling all this data over the years enabled researchers to develop what's called a deep phenotype for the individuals, an indication of the rate of aging, even showing that different organ systems were aging at different rates. But why do some organ systems age faster than others? Researchers aren't sure, but it could be because organs are made of different tissues, which in turn are made of different kinds of cells. Some cell types have faster turnover than others. For example, the small intestine replaces its epithelial cells about every 4 days, but neuron turnover in the brain can take decades. Each time a cell divides, it contributes to aging. But cell turnover doesn't explain why organ aging seems to differ between individuals. The culprits there seem likely to be the usual suspects: your genes and your lifestyle. You could be born predisposed to premature aging in a particular organ just based on small variations in your DNA. As for lifestyle, it could be things like stress, habits, or medical history that influence organ aging. More data will give us a better understanding of what factors cause an organ's biological and chronological ages to diverge, but it's likely you have some control over your ages. One of the study's authors had some ideas. Metabolic agers could exercise more, kidney agers could drink more water, liver agers could cut back on alcohol, and immune teenagers could take anti-inflammatories like turmeric. Of course, these systems are still related. Just because you have different ages for your immune system and your liver doesn't mean they're totally independent of each other. An anti-aging intervention for one system can have overall benefits. In this video, we've mostly focused on one study, but heterogeneous aging is an active area of research. Another team of scientists used the same massive data set to identify five ages: the reproductive system, sensory systems, gastrointestinal system, nervous system, and connective tissue. Using a larger group of participants, yet another team added five more ages to the original four: cardiovascular, physical fitness, sex hormones, facial skin features, and gut microbiome. And other researchers split the brain into three ages: gray matter, white matter, and brain connectivity, along with seven other organ systems. So how many ages do we have? Well, it depends. Turns out age is just a number. Or maybe it's 10 numbers. The point is, your age doesn't define you, and you have more agency to change it than you might think. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of interactive lessons in science, computer science, and math. Brilliant's multivariable functions course can help you learn about what tools you can use to analyze complex systems that are all around us, from the economy to the weather and, yes, our own bodies. Some people learn about that complicated stuff in college courses, but Brilliant makes learning accessible to everyone. Their courses are developed alongside experts from accredited universities like University of Chicago and Duke. To try it yourself for free for 30 days, visit brilliant.org/scishow or click the link in the description down below. That link also gives you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription. Thanks for watching.